Welcome back everybody to LEGO Speed Champions. So I've been doing a fair bit of exploring on this game while in between episodes, and yeah, as a result I have found several of those alien debris collectible things that you gotta find, so I've only got a few of those left to find, but unfortunately those last few are unavailable to be seen on the actual map like all the others were, so yeah. Got them to look forward to, but while exploring I actually have found the barn find that we need to unlock when we get 4,000 bricks, so yeah, pretty sure it's not going to unlock now. I found it via following a bunch of bonus cubes. Yeah, pretty sure it's not going to unlock now because obviously you need to get the 4,000 bricks, but yeah, I found it. So yeah, I'm going to have to remember it's over here. I'll do that for myself, so yes, there, in between the Trailblazer and this corner here, so yeah, pretty much this forest, so that's just pretty much to remind myself of that. So yeah, because obviously I've been doing a lot of things out in between episodes, we now have the Master Builder's House extension unlocked, so let's get over there and see what it's all about, and then see if we've, how far off we are getting whatever else is to be unlocked afterwards. So yeah, not entirely the most appropriate car to be driving around off-road in this, but this is quick on the on-road. One of my favourite DLC cars. Across some weird challenges while free roaming around. I mean, I collided with a biplane at one point and that for some reason gave me some bricks and other things, so yeah, you're just generally free roaming around and just enjoying the scenery and enjoying the roads does offer up some additional bricks that you might well not have been expecting, which is always good. I did like the surprise. It does mean though that this was unlocked a bit ahead of the schedule, but nonetheless. Let's just see what we're going to be having on offer. See if we can make our house even more ludicrously big. How tall is it going to get now? Well, not any taller. Well, yeah, it has actually, yeah. That's taller than the previous extension, and we've got a super wheel spin out of it as well as new brick challenges. So yeah, gaining bricks does obviously give you more bricks to unlock, so that is all good and everything. Oh, we've unlocked oh, we've got the McLaren Senna. Just have to wait for this to tick down. No, I do not want to be in the Horizon life. Also get the McLaren Senna as well for all the bricks that I've collected, so yeah, get to race that around now. Should be fun. We have obviously tried it in the Horizon story and the light, but now we can drive it whenever we want.
Factory once. It was amazing. Never thought I'd work on the Lego version.
So yeah, really rather detailed again for a Lego car. Obviously they made a full life version of it for E3, which was really cool. Alright, so we're going to get another 345 bricks to get a football pitch at our house. Can't say I'm really into football, but nonetheless, it's something to work towards, and we've got this new race to do. Let's get over there.
Destination. arrived at your destination.
Right. Lego McLaren Senna Speed Champions Race. So yeah, we had to do one of these with the Ferrari 40. So yeah, all the same stats as the standard car, so I have a hell of a lot of horsepower, fair decent amount of torque, not much in the way of weight, and yeah, not quite as bang on in terms of weight distribution as I would like. It's certainly more biased to the rear, but because you've got all that grip from the downforce, it really doesn't all that matter when you are going fast enough to get that downforce giving you all the handling that you need. Does obviously not help when you're going slowly around corners, but outside of that it's pretty good. So let's see what it can do in comparison to the standard vehicle. Can't say I'm a massive fan of McLaren Senna, but yeah, still pretty formidable in terms of other cars that are in this class.
And get this, he staked his car on the win. Poor bloke's obviously never seen what you and I could do with a few Lego bricks.
Yeah, just a shame that it's again a car that I already have, but oh well. Should get us some good reward bricks for coming first. One thing that does annoy me is that I know that there are obviously plenty of Lego versions of real life cars out there that you can buy, so it does boggle the mind that they didn't put even more in. Well, I'm sure a lot of people would have liked the Bugatti Chiron to be in as well. But I would have liked some more original ones to be in, you know, like an original Land Rover or Transit van or something. We're going to have to restart this unfortunately, because we don't necessarily be, we're not necessarily very good with this car, which is usually the way with these much faster and more downforce orientated vehicles. I'm just not used to the incredible handling and the amount of speed that you can carry through corners unlike normal vehicles, so I'm used to going in a lot slower vehicles with worse handling, because they're usually the kind of vehicles that I enjoy driving. Weird, I know, but that's just the way I am. Corner again just gets me. Guess I just don't brake enough or put on the power too early. Yeah, but if this is a real person on the game that's done it, or just AI, I don't know, but you know, mightily quick. Maybe I'm just mightily slow. One or the other. Thank you. what is it with this car? I know I took 2 goals to try and win with the Ferrari F40, but with this one, I don't know why. I'm just not really all that great with it. Which I guess probably just shows how little I've actually driven this vehicle in the game. Certainly stop form. Not used to what it can and can't do, really. I do apologise. I don't like to constantly restart, but obviously we need to win this to progress. Much better through that corner. Getting the driving line right. Much better for there. Yes. Doing much better this time round. Yes. Well, it does take a lot of practice, obviously, with a vehicle like this that's, you know, fine-tuned to doing certain things in a certain way. Obviously, if your driving style does not fit that way that the vehicle's been set up, then obviously you are going to struggle. Moment consider myself to be all that great at driving. But that does not dull my passion for these kind of games, and certainly doesn't dull my passion for cars in general. Oh dear, completely ripped the front off there. Understeering into that wall did not help. No. Yeah, don't get distracted. Don't look behind you. Ignore the fact that you just crashed. Well, that was very close. So yeah, apologise for the numerous restarts there, but we eventually got it. Not by much, but we got it nonetheless. Got an achievement for that as well. Which is all good. Yeah, just slightly annoyed that that took so long to do in the first place, to be honest. So you got 50 bricks for that. Which is, again, handy when you're after more than 300. So we need 295 more to get.
Your next upgrade instructions are for a Lego, football pitch. Is the ball made of Lego? Surely that wouldn't. We'll figure it out later. Off you go and collect the bricks.
So yeah, that's what we need to get in terms of the energy cells from the aliens. Like I said, we've got a few more of those to get. I think there's one left on the map and maybe two to get that are only visible by actual sight, not on the actual map itself, which is, yeah, a little annoying, I guess. 5 ultimate pass skills in 5 minutes, we could do that, I guess. So, 110 mile an hour for 110 seconds in the EB110. That sounds pretty hard considering that we're on short roads for most of the time, but I guess we could go to the raceway and just go loop round. While doing the Plymouth Cuda, perform 20 ultimate drafting skills. I'd have to settle that with racing or challenging people on the open road. From 100 ultimate clean racing skill, that's just something you're going to be gathering over time. So yeah, as you can see, there's plenty to do here. 75, collect 20 bonus boards. We're a few off that, to be honest. I think we're going to really just go and see what roads we've got left to drive on and get a nice 200 bricks towards that. Don't think we've got all that many to do, to be honest. I think it's mainly around the speedway. Yeah, you got this road here and there's probably something there to do, so yeah, let's fast travel over there and unlock the roads, and then we can get some nice handy points, and then we'll do some racing over at the speedway as well. See what this car's like around the track. Three more to get. There's two in there, and there's should be one somewhere else that we should find.
In 100 yards, turn right.
No, Anna, I will not. I'm unlocking roads, not doing drift zones. Right, so that's that one done. Where is this final one? So it's difficult with this area because obviously you can't see it on the map. That looks all found. Pretty sure we found everything in the town. Yeah, that looks all right. See, it could literally just be a sliver of a road that have just not happened to have gone along perfectly. Usually is the way it was the way with the main game. It's gonna be anywhere, it's gonna be in one of the towns, or the town. Can't see anything that's greyed out in this racetrack. Probably fairly easy to miss something in the town when there's so many icons all on the map. So now that we've got rid of them, we can see better. Oh yeah, I can see it there. There's a little sliver that is just... I hope that's a road. It does look like it to me. A little bit of a grey. There we go. Oh, it's only 100. Oh well, it's something towards the overall goal. And got an achievement as well for it. Which is fine by me. Right. Races. There's a cross-country race on the Falcon Indy Circuit. Yeah, we'll do that one. Let's go back. Yeah, well over halfway with the bricks as well, the bonus cubes even, as well as the bricks, because as you can see we're on 2,805 and we need 4,000 for the barn find, which is what I'm really looking forward to, and yeah, we've not got that many to get until we get to 3,000. I'll just put everything back on the map, just so you guys can see it. There's a beauty spot over here we haven't looked at yet. Oasis. Not the band, thankfully. But a literal oasis.
Hunting for Lego dinosaurs in the beautiful Lego forest? Better bring along your Lego binoculars. And possibly a Lego first aid kit.
And a Lego off-roader, but we don't have one of them outside of the Mini. That's not really an off-roader. Or a rally car, to be honest. But I think that's all the beauty spots, yeah. As you can see on the alien map front, there's one here I need to get, but there are more than one left to get. Either I'm blind or I just can't see it, because yeah, I did find one that wasn't on the map, so I think there's one or two left to get that you have to actually find yourself. I'll just go to the part of the map that where it is. So yeah, that's again something we'll do over time. Obviously you can only do it at night.
You have arrived at your destination.
I've already done this, why is it making me do it again? Maybe it's a championship. Yeah. I don't know. Don't know why it's saying that I've not done it, but we'll try it. At least we'll show off what this car can do on these track, on this track, at least one variant of it. Certainly be interesting to see what it can do up against other similar cars, not just itself, like before. The grip for that corner then. I think this car has on its side, even though it is only rear wheel drive, just has lots and lots of grip, whereas the likes of a Zenvo just doesn't. I've always found that car to be a little bit wayward in its handling. That checkpoint, unfortunately. Oh dear, curbs playing havoc with the handle in there. I wish it was just a lap race, not checkpoints. So yeah, it doesn't make it difficult on a track to stick to a checkpoint area. Oh yeah, I know why it says we need to win it, because we didn't win it last time, did we? We only came fourth again in this race in the Vauxhall, so we're going to restart it and try and come first this time around, because we are in a much faster car, much more capable of handling against similar competition this time around. So let's give it our all. be such a point again. I mean, I was cutting the corner somewhat. Fair on his handling as well as it is around this track. Very straight orientated. Surprised with the shear on as well. Not surprised by the Aventador at all though. Honestly, we're just going to need more and more practice with this circuit and the right car, because, yeah, we've come fourth again, or at least we can try and get third at least, but yeah, first and second is eluding us, really, to be honest. Yeah, we're going to have to deal with fourth again. God damn it. Yeah, don't really know what we're going to have to do to get into that extra bit, really. Because, yeah, we're not going to win any bricks from that. I do apologise again. More restarts, more failures. Instead, let's go do the other one that we haven't done. There's also another one in the centre that we haven't done either. Stick with this. Hopefully the handling will make up for the lesser element in terms of speed, because it is pretty much just a loop. And even though this car's quick, it's not the quickest in terms of speed. It's no good doing 200 mile an hour if you can't keep it up around the corner. They're breaking. I can pounce. Oh well, I would have been able to if that wall wasn't there. Due to its weight and the all-wheel drive system, the Veyron just does not end the corners like this that well. And I didn't anticipate those two coming together and therefore braking really hard. To set off a second. Didn't really make our way for the pack quite as quick, and obviously we're not in the fastest of cars in terms of speed, whereas the Agera RS is monumental in terms of its top speed. So we did have the fastest lap though, as you can see, but yeah, that doesn't much mean much when you're not able to work your way through a pack. you know, could be worse. Could have been a fourth place that last time. We'll unpick that challenge because we're not going to do that today. So, yeah. Again, these are all going to accumulate over time because we did get one when we were racing and I don't know what it was for. So, yeah. Don't forget, I actually own the Bugatti EB110 to be honest, so that's the car I'm going to have to actually fork out my own pocket to try and get it. But yeah, as you can see, there are plenty of more challenges to do. We're not that far off in terms of bonus cubes, I don't think. We'll do the wheel spins and I'll just show you how far I am through the bonus cubes. Yay, big wad of cash there, 425 grand. Doubt we'll get anywhere near that with this. Nope. Car I already own. Where do we look at our stats? Yeah, so I've got 21 of the 25 alien parts or whatever they are. None of the alien plants yet, because I've just not seen them. Cubes. Yeah, 385, so we're only 115 off. Which is not bad, to be honest. So, yeah, I think we're going to call it for there now. We have not got that many more to get until we get our football pitch, but I'm more interested in, you know, Horizon Story and getting those collectibles, to be honest. But again, that's just something that's going to have to happen over time. But we at least did win the McLaren Senna Speed Champion race, and took us some time, but we did eventually get it. And yeah, we are obviously making our way slowly through the game, but yeah, we're not all that far off getting to the Barnes Find, which is the ultimate goal really. So yeah, I am looking forward to that, but nonetheless, thanks for watching, and I do apologise for the plenty of restarts that happened during this episode, but that's just the way it goes sometimes. You don't always get lucky or you know, get the wins that you were hoping for. Nonetheless, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.